وعليكم السلام.
Spoke on war on Muslims in America, secret societies, governments. I'd like to know your sentiments.
The media attitude towards Muslim, it is rather unfortunate, and that's why I was talking earlier about media stereotypes. Let me give you one example, and I'm not going to use any strong term. I use whatever term to designate it. But, for example, when a Jew killed Rabin, you did not find big letters in the newspaper saying Judaic terrorism or Jewish terrorism killed Rabin. And I'm not suggesting that this should be the case. When David Koresh, in the Waco incident, committed whatever act they committed, including murder, nobody came in the paper and said, Christian terrorism. They call it Davidian branch, cult. Only when the matter relates to somebody from Muslim background or Arabian background, that the name of Islam is deliberately dragged. Not only sometimes they're saying Muslim terrorist or Muslim fundamentalist, whatever other term, sometimes you use the term even Islamic terrorism. It's just like saying this is Judaic terrorism, that is emanating from Judaism. This is Christian terrorism, that means Christianity teaches it. Obviously, it gives that impression. Islamic terrorism, it's something related to Islam somehow and connected with the normative teaching of the. That's why I included that as part of the introduction. So that shows that there are different standards. For other religions, say, all right, no, religion doesn't teach that. These are freaks, that there is fringe people, fanatical, violent fringe in any religion. So that's fine, we can excuse that. But only in the case of Islam, no. There is no need to admit that there could be also a fanatical or violent fringe among Muslims, like any other followers of any other religions at any point of time. No, it has to be Islamic. The name has to be always put in the picture. And then you get those self-styled experts who make very irresponsible statements resulting in great damage to the Muslim community in North America. People like Steve Emerson appearing, being like a hot cake after the Oklahoma City bombing, that this carries the fingerprints of Middle Eastern terrorism. And obviously people, and the rumors spread, some Middle Eastern looking people. And I don't know, and by any stretch of imagination, if McVeigh looked like a Middle Eastern, you know. I don't know, Middle Eastern within Canada, within the United States, maybe Midwestern or Middle Eastern, but not within the world. But the point here, irresponsible statements like that, even the speculation, but I'm not talking about media people in training, that's no problem. I'm talking about those who deliberately are committing those distortion. And as a result, you hear until today even about destruction and burning of Muslim mosques, attack physically on them, a woman who lost her child because during the Oklahoma City things, her house was stoned and the glass were broken. She was so scared. This is the kind of irresponsibility that, in spite of the effort now of some organizations and the good work done by CARE, the Council on American Islamic Relations, we find that great deal of irresponsibility resulting from that baggage. Or God knows, maybe there might be some cases where some people are deliberately, like Emerson and others, deliberately presenting a dishonest picture of Islam and try to incite hatred against the Muslim community in North America and elsewhere. I'm sorry to be frank, but I have to.